This is a rusty sharp, and it is rust, it's not muck, and today's the day it is getting replaced. I don't want to get tetanus off a microwave. This microwave is going away to be replaced by somebody called Russell. Yes. Now, when it arrived, this bash was already in it, so I'm hoping everything's going to be fine. This is actually the same microwave my mum and my dad have got. Well, actually, no, it isn't. My mum and dad still have their microwave. I didn't just take their microwave and run away. It's the same model. Is it the same model? You know what I mean? Anyway, Russell Hobbs, family size, and it's still a flatbed one because I love this. I love the non-spinningness because that means when I'm doing reviews, whatever I put in comes out the same way. It's not a up-to-chance thing if it stops the right way. It's just a shame this one rusted. But it is about 4, maybe 5 years old. And I've never had a microwave that's rusted on me before, but I know it is a thing that can happen. Right, so now we must switch you off. Oh, I've heard beep at least. Like putting something off, turning off the life support machine. Oh well, that is it. Oh, it's still plugged in. Is it going to reach the floor? Just. Oh well. Now the unboxing of this one. It's a good job I know that it still fits underneath the cupboard. Right, I need some scissors. And let's see what we get inside. A microwave, hopefully. This actually arrived a couple of days ago. And I was going to do a much bigger thing about it, but I thought, actually, I just want to get it open and working. I'm halfway through filming the entire eggs range from Iceland, so this is going to look a bit bizarre halfway through. This was quite a big expense, so please watch my videos, please watch an advert before you automatically skip past that 5 seconds. Please watch an advert and it'll help me pay this off. Polystyrene. I like polystyrene. I even like the word polystyrene. Instruction book, which I shall read like this. And here is the microwave, which is back to front. I have to get it out of the box on the floor. Oh, I tried doing it on camera, but it's bigger than the other microwave. Oh, there we go. There we go. And it looks a similar size now I've got it out of the box. La-da! There we are. Oh, this one doesn't sucker to the table like the other one did. I hope it's heavy enough so when I open and shut it, it doesn't move. I think it's alright like that. I don't think my mum and dad have that problem with theirs. Right. Got it off of Amazon. It was £129.90. Something like that. And where's my plug? Oh! It's bashed me in on the side of the flipping cooker hood. Oh, that hurt. Take the tape off. Unwind the impossibly annoying windy sandwich wrap metal thing. Oh, come on. There we go. Plug you in. Please don't go bang. No, but I've got a lovely beep. Oops, I turned you on by mistake. Clear. Right. Take off the plastic and inside, look at that. This is much better because as you can see, the seal comes all the way to the edge and it's got a much bigger plate on the bottom of it. If I turn the camera a bit, you'll see. And if I zoom you in a bit more, you'll see. There you are, it's a bit better. Inside, it's a little darker because it's not painted white. But, yeah, look. The seal goes all the way to the edge. So whatever spills... Is that a mark? Yes, it was. A little bit of spit will get rid of that. And, yes. That's lovely. It's 800 watt. So it's 100 less than the last one, but that doesn't really matter. I'm not too fussed about that. 800 is a pretty much a standard wattage for your microwaves in the UK. The one that previous at 900 was unusual. Oh, it's a bit more of a mirrored finish. Hello, you can see everything. You can see that I'm only wearing shorts. Look, I've got my legs out. Just set the time. It's really easy to set the clock. And all you do is press clock, then it starts flashing. And you press your up and down clock, up and down again for your minutes, and then clock, and then it's set. Really nice and easy, because sometimes on microwave, setting the time is a complete pain in the backside. And oh, God, these reflections. I've got my legs out, which you don't normally see. Let's open the microwave. Inside, you can see it's all grey. There's a nice bright light. And I just like this microwave. I don't know where that accent came from. It's like a really bad Brummie accent. I like this microwave. Let's get in. A brand new Cathedral City mac and cheese, new to exclusive to Island. Right, how many minutes have I got to do this for? 8 minutes, nice and easy. 8 minutes. Now the buttons on the side are very limited. Now my mum and my dad just constantly hit the start button because it does it in 30 second thingamajigsies, which is what I'm going to do myself. I'll figure out the actual timings in a moment. In fact, Sherlock is reading the instruction manual now. The blue LEDs, which is fairly a common thing at the moment, isn't it? The blue. I'm thinking it's starting to go a little out of fashion now. I've had enough of it. I would have liked a good old-fashioned green, actually. Maybe a red, even. I don't know why. I'm getting fed up of blue.
Are you?
Let me know in the comment section down below. Flipping heck, this is mirrory, isn't it? It's like, can see me, hello! I hope this isn't going to be some sort of pain to keep clean. You can barely see the food inside on camera, but I can see it almost clearly. And it's non-spinning look, it just stays there. Which I think is a safer thing, because on a spinny microwave, when it's spinning away, sometimes it stops at an angle that you can't get your hands in with the oven gloves. And obviously I've got asbestos fingers, so I don't normally have that problem, but sometimes when it's at a weird angle, I don't want to put my hand over steam trying to get something out the microwave. While I'm waiting for my mac and cheese to cook, a microwave is one of those appliances that you probably do leave unattended whilst it's in operation, isn't it? You know how they always say, oh, you shouldn't leave anything switched on unattended. Yeah, well, what about your fridge? What about your freezer? You don't turn them off every time you go out, do you? No. And it's pretty much the same with your microwave, isn't it? You know, it's got a timer on it, and you sort of just trust it to get onto what it's doing. The smell at the moment has got that new smell, so it's got that new electronic smell. And I dare say it's a touch quieter than the previous microwave. Oh, this one. But then that one was 4 years old, so maybe this one, that one started out quieter. And I don't think Russell Hobbs is quite international, but it's a brand that's been in the UK forever. So people know what Russell Hobbs is in the UK. It's not a premium brand, but it's, I don't want to say the word trusted, but it's one of them brands that's a good one. You associate it with being good. You know, it's not as if I've gone to Argos and got a Bush one, or one of Argos' own brands. It's not as if, you know what I mean, it's a good one. It's not a supermarket own brand, obviously, either. Yes. How's it doing? Oof. Now, I've got asbestos fingers, so don't do what I'm doing, because that is hot. As I reach, just going to turn that oven light off because I think it's making it flicker. Now as I get to the final 30 seconds of the microwave in its first cookage, it's got two symbols flashing. There's like a wavy C one, which I'm presuming is microwave,
But I don't know what the other one means because it's got the lands going up in a circle. I don't know what those symbols mean just yet. But we'll find out. We will find out. Now, it's usual what microwaves do these days, where it starts clicking off in the last couple of seconds. I think that's a safety thing, so that food's not searing, steaming hot as soon as you open the door. What's it beep like? See, the correct amount! 5 beeps! 5! It just sounds more complete. This stupid one did 4! You know? It's either a bell or 5 beeps! Not 4! Anyway. Ooh, it's just 10 to 6 o'clock. Right, this is very hot. Don't do what I'm doing. There we go. Already, I've touched that rather than touching the handle. I'll have to get used to that. Ah, because I bet this is going to be a fingerprint trap. And yeah, it's cooked. I mean, it's a microwave. What was you expecting? You know, was it expecting it to, I don't know, explode or something and turn into a fire engine? I don't know. Yes. Good, good, good. Different fork. And it has cooked everything searing hotly. Yes, very hot. And there we go. I'll see how this tastes in a minute. I'll never cool down because I don't have an asbestos tongue to boil the not cheese, obviously. I can happily sip hot tea, but really, I think cheese is somewhere between napalm and centre of the sun hot, isn't it? So I'll let that cool down for a couple of minutes. And we'll see how well it's cooked. Since I've left it for many minutes. See what this is like. I'm not really a big fan of mac and cheese, but I wanted something that was high fat because it'd be more obvious if some bits have cooked and some haven't. Mmm, this is lovely. Yeah. Because some of the Amazon complaints was that it didn't cook evenly. Now, all microwaves can have cold spots, but this is fine. This is absolutely fine. It's got really good reviews on Amazon. It's got 4.5 stars out of 5 stars for thousands of reviews, I think it was. Oh, just a lot. The thing is, halfway through, you're supposed to check it anyway and put it in a different way and it'll be fine. I like the non-spinningness. Oh, I'm still doing that, look. I've got to stop doing that. That's probably going to be your biggest down, especially if your old microwave had a bezel on the door. I'm going to have to keep remembering to use the handle only. Because this is turning into a bit of a fingerprint magnet. Which, I mean, it looks great, but depending where it is in your kitchen, I suppose if you've got kids, good luck trying to keep this smudge free. Because all kids are going to just do that. But yeah, it's a lovely microwave. To get it going, you just hold down the start button. As many uses as you can. Don't operate it without in, obviously. It did slide a bit then, but I can put it against the back of the wall a bit better. But, yes, it's a lovely microwave. My mum and dad got it from Amazon as well. I think they paid roughly the same price. And they've had theirs for about 3 years now. Maybe 2 years. And it works absolutely fine. Absolutely fine. And they love it. It's a good microwave. I recommend you get this microwave if you need a new microwave. Especially this flatbed thing. Should now in the 21st century be a standard on microwaves because that glass thing as well, spinning around, is a pain to keep clean. Whereas this, you can just get a bit of kitchen roll and just wipe it out dead easy. And the other one went rusty, but that was a different make. That was made by Sharp. But I think with better materials, which I think this one has actually, I think it's going to be... Oh, I'm still doing that! Stop it! I think it's going to be good. Anyway, thanks for watching. Scrabs. Bye!